This is Question of the Week from BU Today. Why did Boston University rename Columbus Day Indigenous Peoples Day? In this episode, Doug Most, executive editor at BU Today, talks to Adrienne Young, a recent graduate of the BU School of Social Work and a member of the Sioux Tribe of Chippewa Indians. As a result of Adrienne's advocacy, the BU School of Social Work began celebrating Indigenous Peoples Day in 2020. Her efforts were also influential in the university-wide decision to officially rename Columbus Day as Indigenous Peoples Day.
We're speaking today with Adrienne Young. We're glad to have you here today to talk to us about why it was important for BU to rename this holiday and sort of what the significance of it is for you. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, sure. Happy to be here.
What prompted you to think that, you know, even though Massachusetts as a state has not made this change, you thought that BU could certainly maybe make its own change? Can you talk about what prompted you to start acting?
So I guess I was prompted because I was surprised that the BU school and the School of Social Work in particular were still recognizing Columbus Day, because it seems like there has been a movement to, correct some of these longstanding harms or issues for marginalized people. And so I thought it was odd that Columbus Day was still being celebrated, especially given other schools in the area had made the shift. I was living in Brookline at the time, who the city itself had also made the shift. And so I thought maybe just sharing some of that information and bringing attention to it might help to steer BU in the right direction.
As a member of the Sioux Tribe yourself, how much did that sort of influence your motivation and sort of desire to sort of do this? Was there a sort of a personal level for you in addition to just a professional and human level?
Absolutely. I mean, as an Indigenous person, I'm always, looking out for Indigenous rights. And unfortunately, it's been something that has to be very present in my life. And, unfortunate that these issues have to be present. I love Native American, but there was a personal issue. I think my family felt very happy and proud when they made the change. So it definitely makes a difference. But I was also, as an Indigenous person, when I moved to Boston, I looked into other Indigenous organizations or ways that I could connect with community in Boston. And the Indigenous Peoples Day MA is a large campaign that's being organized that has a bill trying to move through the state legislature. They actually had a hearing on it last night. So I, checked in with them and heard more about their campaign, saw where they were making a difference, and used a lot of their resources and information to try and make it happen at BU.
Why was it so important that BU rename a holiday that's been in place for so long?
Sure. I think overall, it's really important for the whole state, the Commonwealth to move past it, for the country to move past it and really embrace Indigenous Peoples Day as a way to celebrate how long we've been here, how long we've stewarded the land sustainably. And for me, I guess the myth of Columbus discovering North America seems just wildly inaccurate. And we didn't discover it. There were Native American people here already and recognizing the land. So, I understand that there's some pushback from Italian Americans who like to see that celebrated. But in the Commonwealth, October is, Italian American Heritage Month. I think that that's really wonderful. And so to just remove this, figure who played a large role in the genocide of our Indigenous people and swap it celebrating Indigenous culture feels like a strong statement to make. And especially in education, where Native American people still are, I think it's hard to be a Native American student. You're oftentimes part of a really small population. And so for schools to do that, for BU to recognize Indigenous Peoples Day, I think is also a step in the right direction in making Indigenous students feel welcome on campus.
When you started the conversation and started reaching out to people, whether it was talking to fellow students or administrators, what was the initial feedback and sort of reaction you heard?
the School of Social Work, the student union in particular is very supportive. And so I was part of a student union. There's a lot of enthusiasm to, you know, remove Columbus Day. And Jorge Delva, who's the dean, has, you know, like I said, really worked with me to help make the school an even more welcoming place for Indigenous students. So I think he was happy to see, you know, everything that I shared with him. He and the Dean of Equity and Inclusion let me know that they would elevate it and do their best, that they couldn't make any promises about the larger school. But last year, Jorge made it official at the School of Social Work in any way that they would recognize Indigenous Peoples Day instead of Columbus Day. So I'm really heartened to see that BU is following suit this year.
Can you go back and talk a little bit about Columbus, right? I mean, in history books, when I think back to how I first learned about Columbus, you're right. We hear of him as he discovered America. Is that a key part of sort of what was driving you, that there's this feeling that the lesson that we're learning in the history books, that students are learning, doesn't tell the complete picture?
Yeah, I mean, I guess I think it's almost comical how celebrated Columbus has been in this story. I mean, he didn't even arrive in this portion of America. I think he arrived in the Caribbean and, you know, did horrible damage there. And so, you know, some of that story is just inflated, similar to how the, you know, the story of Thanksgiving and that the tribe here welcoming pilgrims is sort of conflated. It really puts a lot of emphasis on the colonizers coming to the U.S. and not enough emphasis, in my opinion, on the Indigenous people. I'd much rather hear and celebrate the stories of Indigenous people in the U.S. and the, you know, their culture and their experiences and how we're still here. And so I think it's really, to me, about just shifting the focus from centering Columbus or, you know, other people who have colonized the U.S. to focusing on the Indigenous people.
So lastly, I mean, I guess the big question that's still out there is, what will it take for this to sort of, you know, happen at the federal level and the holiday itself gets renamed?
I follow when, you know, new states approve it. I followed the hearing last night and I'm really supportive of states recognizing Indigenous Peoples Day. It would be awesome if it happened federally. But for me, I guess this is just one step. It's a holiday. There's lots of Indigenous issues happening across the U.S. with the Indian Child Welfare Act, some of the pipelines going through Native lands, not honoring the treaties that you know, we have a right to. And so I think that the holiday would be great, but I'd love to see, you know, more action on all of these different types of issues. That's really what I pay attention to, is kind of national Indigenous legislation. Read Indian Country Today to follow up on, you know, Native issues and just immerse myself in all of that is important. And I hope that fellow BU students will maybe take some time on the holiday to do that as well.
I'm glad we were able to talk to you, Adrienne. Thank you for joining us. We appreciate the time that you took with us today.
Of course. Thanks so much.
Thanks to Adrienne Young for joining us on this episode of Question of the Week. To learn more about the campaign to make Indigenous Peoples Day an official state holiday in Massachusetts, go to indigenouspeoplesdayma.org. You can also find the link to the campaign in the show notes. And while you're there, please remember to rate, share, and review us on your podcast app of choice. I'm Dana Ferrante. See you next week.